Gout is the most common form of inflammatory arthritis in today's society. It was formerly known as the disease of kings, as it commonly afflicted the wealthy because only they could afford meat-heavy diets coupled with high alcohol consumption. Major dietary risk factors for gout. Nowadays, most people in Western society can eat and drink like the kings and queens of the past, but maybe we shouldn't. The main mechanism of gout is the overabundance of uric acid in the body, which can then crystallize in the urinary tract, kidneys, in tissue and joints. The inflammatory response to uric acid crystals in tissue and joints can cause extreme pain during gout attacks. The risk for uric acid kidney stones increases. So, what roles do genetics and diet play? Can we improve gout symptoms with diet? Maybe even prevent it entirely? Remember to subscribe to our channel. Kidney health and uric acid. In healthy individuals, excess uric acid is excreted via the kidneys. When kidney function declines and/or uric acid clearance is inhibited, uric acid can start to build up in the bloodstream. The clearance of uric acid also depends on the pH value of the urine, which depends on the acid and base forming potential of one's diet. Highly acid forming foods like meat, cheese, chocolate, and processed grain products should be avoided. The consumption of base forming foods like most vegetables should be increased. Genetics play a role in gout because they can affect the uric acid clearance. But the healthier your kidneys are, the smaller the negative influence of your genes becomes. Diet plays a major role in gout prevention, because many chronic diseases that contribute to a decline in kidney function can often be prevented, some even reversed, by following a healthy dietary pattern and lifestyle. The majority of people eating a Western dietary pattern develop chronic kidney disease in their lifetime, massively increasing their risk of gout. Gut health and uric acid. Gout patients show a characteristic gut dysbiosis affecting uric acid breakdown and short-chain fatty acid production in the gut. This gut dysbiosis contributes to higher blood uric acid levels and increased systemic inflammation, which affects the occurrence and severity of gout. A disturbed gut microbiota also damages liver and kidney health via toxic metabolites like ammonia and secondary bile acids. It also plays a role in insulin resistance, the main mechanism of type 2 diabetes. Gut health is a very complex topic. When possible, eating a large amount and diversity of fiber and resistant starch is the most important aspect of improving gut health, boosting short-chain fatty acid production, inhibiting the formation of toxic metabolites, and binding and excreting all kinds of waste products out of the system. Once uric acid buildup is too high, and uric acid clearance has declined to insufficient levels due to declined kidney function, with or without a genetic component, dietary restrictions to prevent the formation of uric acid are advised. Steps to improve uric acid clearance again should not be forgotten. Purines and uric acid. Uric acid is a breakdown product of purines, an organic compound that makes up part of all genetic materials. Purines are thus found in most foods, and most foods affect uric acid levels in one way or another. They can contain purines, which are broken down into uric acid. They can stimulate purine synthesis, which are then broken down into uric acid. They can improve or worsen inflammation, which affects gut and kidney health and is directly linked to gout pain. Or they affect gut health and uric acid excretion via the kidneys in other ways. Thus, the overall acute and long-term effect of a food item on gout depends on various factors. Let's take a look at various food groups to determine their effect on gout. Purines in meat and seafood. The standard dietary advice for gout patients includes staying away from meat and seafood. This is great advice. Meat and seafood are high in purines, which are easily absorbed and broken down into uric acid. Meat and seafood are known to increase inflammation via trans fats, saturated fats, oxidized cholesterol, heme iron, etc. They contain no fiber nor resistant starch to improve gut health. Quite the opposite, The breakdown of fat and protein in the gut increases its pH value, fostering a pathological alkaline environment, producing more toxic metabolites and thus more gut complications. In addition, these acid-forming foods put a strain on the kidneys, also via the inflammatory kidney response called hyperfiltration mode, and reduce uric acid clearance. We can see that the acute and long-term effects of meat and seafood on gout are negative. Purine-rich plant foods. So what about legumes like beans and lentils, which are also high in purines? Outdated diet recommendations for gout did indeed advise against the consumption of beans and lentils. We now know that the long-term consumption of these purine-rich plant foods does not increase uric acid levels. There are various possible explanations. For once, the bioavailability of the purines is low, meaning they are locked inside plant cell walls. Beans and lentils are also known to quench inflammation and massively improve gut health, improving short-chain fatty acid production and possibly also uric acid breakdown in the gut. Plant protein is also much gentler on your kidneys compared to animal protein. Overall, plant protein is linked to a lower risk of gout, so do not stay away from purine-rich plant foods. Alcohol and fructose. Alcohol and isolated fructose spike uric acid levels. Beer and liquor are closely linked to an increased risk of gout. The data on wine is mixed, but better stay away from it as well. The purine content of these beverages is low, but the metabolism of ethanol increases purine synthesis and blocks uric acid clearance by the kidneys. Isolated fructose is found in sugary foods, sugar-sweetened beverages, and fruit juices. Again, the purine content itself is not the deciding factor. It is the rapid metabolism of isolated fructose that spikes uric acid. This does not pertain to fructose found in whole fruits. Whole fruits having a high water content and fiber to slow down digestion have a completely different metabolic effect. It might still not be a good idea to wolf down a pound of grapes. Dairy, coffee, and cherries. Low-fat dairy products have been shown to lower blood uric acid levels in the short term. So the acute effects should be deemed positive, especially for skim milk. The long-term effects are less conclusive. No significant lowering in uric acid levels after 2 months of daily skim milk consumption. Skim milk is a potent trigger of the pathological signaling pathway mTOR, linked to acne, depression, obesity, and type 2 diabetes. The long-term risks and benefits should be considered carefully. Coffee seems to have a mild protective effect against gout, probably via chlorogenic acid, which we talked about in a recent video. There is a lot of promising data on using cherries for gout treatment. As cherries are not in season all year round, cherry juice concentrate was tested in controlled interventional trials with positive results. A teaspoon of cherry juice concentrate twice a day showed significant benefits within a few months. So give it a try. Let's summarize. Gout is a very common, very painful inflammatory arthritis. The main mechanism of gout is the crystallization of excess uric acid in the urinary tract, kidneys, tissue, and joints. The buildup of uric acid in the blood heavily depends on the health status of the kidneys and also the gut microbiota. There is a genetic component which influences uric acid clearance, increasing the risk of gout even with healthier kidneys. Purine-rich animal products like meat and seafood should be avoided. The acute and long-term effects of these foods on gout are negative. Purine-rich whole plant foods should not be avoided. They don't increase uric acid levels and are beneficial in terms of kidney and gut health. Alcohol and isolated fructose trigger purine synthesis, which spikes uric acid levels. They should be avoided. Whole fruits are fine to eat. Low-fat dairy products, especially skim milk, show acute benefits by lowering uric acid levels. The long-term benefits are not conclusive. Coffee and cherry consumption might help prevent attacks of gout. They are worth giving a try. Thanks for watching. Feel free to share this video with your friends and family, especially with those at higher risk because of close family members with gout. See you in the next video!